In this video, we'll walk through the steps of getting your descriptor data into Dedoose. Descriptor data are the demographic, categorical, and quantitative information that we know about our research participants and the settings they live in. These are the data that we want to link to our documents so we can integrate the descriptor information with the qualitative data and all our excerpting and coding activity. Once linked, we can carry out both qualitative and mixed methods data analysis, which is where Dedoose really shines. The first step is to create a set that's going to hold information about the variables that we're going to use. So for example, for individuals, we might include an ID variable. Here we can provide a description. I can define the variable type. I'll call this a number field. Submit that. We might also have variable for sex. I'm going to create an option list variable here and set the values. And we'll submit that. Maybe a variable for their names. Leave that as a text field. But there's a much faster way to do this, since most researchers have these kinds of data already organized in other software. So we can simply import all of this information directly to Dedoose from Excel files. So I'm going to delete this set and get it all fresh. Here's what my data look like inside of Excel. I've got my column headers with the variables and all my data records down here. So first, I'm going to need to create a file with all the data definitions. So I prepare a second Excel file. Here, my first column is all my variable names. Then there are three other pieces of information that I need to provide for Dedoose to properly read the data when they come in. The memo field here is where I can provide a description. This is optional. I need to define the data type. And then if it's a list type of variable, I need to provide the values. So here's a list type. The values that are valid would be male and female, child ethnicity, Hispanic, African American, for example. You can see here that I've used a number of list type fields. We really encourage users to use as many list type fields as possible inside of Dedoose, since so many of the great data visualizations depend on these data. Many continuous variables, like age or scores on a measure of depression, can also be converted to list type. We accomplish this by examining the distribution of scores and then deciding on reasonable and meaningful cut points. So for example, we might be able to convert depression scores to three groupings, high, medium, and low, and then include this variable as a list type in Dedoose. We also have a great grouping feature in Dedoose that actually does this conversion for you automatically, and you'll get a glimpse of that in just a minute. So with my two files ready, I'm ready to import them into Dedoose. So I click here to import the fields, locate the file with the definitions, click open, get a quick glimpse of my variables and the values, and I'm also going to set one of the fields here, a variable I've called time, as a dynamic descriptor field. Dynamic fields are an awesome feature in Dedoose that let you set the value of a descriptor field when linking individual documents. So there's a variety of information in our descriptor sets that identify an individual. But where we want a descriptor value to be set specific to a document, we can define that descriptor field as dynamic and then set the value each time the linking is done. You'll see more on that in the video on document creation and excerpting. Here I'm prompted to import the set into a selected set. We don't have any sets defined yet, so I'm going to create a new set and import to new set. Now all my fields are ready to go. Here's the button to import the descriptor data. I'm going to go ahead and click that, find my file, go ahead and open that. And here are our data in the viewer. I intentionally left a few fields empty and entered some errant data to show how import error detection works. I can exit here, fix the data, and then conduct my import. Or I can continue with this import, leaving the errant values or empty fields as missing data. I'm going to go ahead and do that. So we can see here where my errors were. I just left missing data in the data table. So there are a few other things going on in the descriptor workspace. First, there are a number of controls. For which data are in view. So here I can clear the fields, choose only a set of variables to look at. I can sort my data by any of these individual columns. And I can also do some filtering. So here's where you get to see this awesome grouping feature. Dedoose uses a magical algorithm to automatically group data that aren't defined as a list type. For example, date of birth is a date field, so Dedoose examines the range of dates, slices it into 7 groups, and then presents the groupings for use in filtering the descriptor data. And here it is with the ID variable. Pretty cool, huh? Dedoose also cues you when you're filtering by turning the Clear Filters button to red when filtering is active, just in case you get worried about where all your data went. And before we end here, there's a few other things I'd like to mention. First, we can immediately see in the chart section that we get a look at the relative number of individuals in our sample in each of the option list variable groups. Then is the use of multiple descriptor sets. Multiple descriptor sets are ideal for conducting multi-level analysis. So for example, if we're studying students and change over time, I might have a set of variables that were associated with each individual, like those we've already defined. But I also might have a set of information that distinguishes schools. So I can create a second descriptor set and have variables in there, things like teacher-child ratio, school zip code, and maybe the number of children in the school. With this type of a setup, I can conduct analysis based on characteristics of the individuals, the schools, or both. There'll be more on this in the videos on document creation and analysis. Another useful feature is the ability to export current descriptor data. And I want to use this feature when I'm adding new cases or new variables to the descriptor set, but I don't want to lose the linkings that I've made between the descriptors and any of the resources in our project. I hope this information gives you a great start and that you'll check out some of our other videos on how to use Dedoose efficiently and effectively in your work.